They get sprayed. Lemonade was a popular drink and it still is. I get more props and stunts than Bruce Willis. A poet like Langston Hughes and can't lose when I cruise out on the expressway. Leaving the bodega, I say suave. Premier's got more beats than Juan's got hate. Clips are inserted into my gun so I can take the money, never have to run. To run.
Your hands, everybody, if you got what it takes. Cause I'm KRS and I'm on the mic. It is on the brakes. Your head.
You know me by now, I doubt you'll ever know. I never want a Grammy, I won't win a Tony, but I'm not the only MC keeping me real. Where to grab the mic to smash rap, girls don't care. Check the diamonds, the diamonds, 1985, whenever I arrive. The party gets wider, flow with the master rhyme. That's only behind the video. You know it's top driver.
You describe your own style. Tell me something about your technique. And
Well, it's not just about technique, and it's my style is everything basically. It's about.
You are not typically a rap DJ. If I can say.
Okay, a typical rap DJ. Well, there's different ways of defining the word DJ nowadays. Mm-hmm. What I'm now considered is a turntablist, and. The difference between a turntablist and a normal DJ is that we don't just play records or play music, we make music. We can make music out of the turntables, you know. Whether we basically make the turntable a sampler and we can put anything in
it. It's a question of creativity.
Yeah, and I just basically incorporate that. And I'm always aware of the audience, you know what I mean? I'm always got my eye on the audience and I listen for the audience, you know. That's why the most important thing to me first is making sure I've got their attention, you know what I mean? Because if I can't feel the crowd, then it does stifle my performance. So that's my weakness, the crowd. But I like to be very vibrant. I like to be one-to-one with my crowd, you know. I don't place myself above them. I don't place myself below them, you know what I mean? And I just try and project a very entertaining show, basically. That's what Cutmaster Swift's about. Obviously, I do work very hard and I take my job very seriously. And you know, maybe that's a reason why I'm a pretty popular DJ, or have been consistent in still being able to come back as a DJ again. You know what I mean? Because I always believe there is a science behind DJing. It's not just a DJ putting a record on, moving it backwards and forwards. You know, there is a science behind it, and a lot of people need to understand this science. You know what I mean? It's not watching videos of other DJs. You know, we all are inspired by other DJs, but at the same time, we've got to be individuals in ourselves. We all have a little something in ourselves to give out, and if we can tap into that, you know, I think it'd be a great thing for anything we want to do. You know, determination, you know, and having the confidence and being able to project that out.
What?
The hip-hop culture in London is very strong. Very underground, but very strong-minded, shall I say. Mm-hmm. The industry isn't 100% behind
us. Do you think on America's rap scene or native London rap scene?
Do I think on that? Well, I don't think about America, and I don't
When you said that it's very strong scene.
Okay, yeah. I don't think about America, and I don't think about London. I just think about...
London.
Yeah, about rap and yes. What I do to it, you know what I mean? What's my gonna be, what's my input into it? Like I said...
But the home of rap, it's
the home of rap is definitely America. Definitely America, but that doesn't mean that no one doesn't have a home either, you know what I mean? The fact is that they can sell something to places like over here who don't, that whose native language ain't English, but we've all had an interest, you know what I mean? We've got to look at how can they sold it to us. So we've got to say, okay, what are we going to sell back to them? Now, I think it's a fact that Americans don't want what they already have. They want something additional. You know what I mean? So we've got to be able to bring our culture to them, you know. They eat pizzas, they eat Chinese food. Yes. Why? Because obviously they like it. If we was going to sell them hamburgers, they may not necessarily like it as much. So we've got to basically be able to sell them our culture as well. And that's why I think we've got to really take seriously and see how we want to do that. Like I said, in the UK though, unfortunately, the music industry isn't 100% behind the rap scene. You know, there is a few that do have made a certain impact on the scene, but you know, with a lot more money and the right backing, there's no reason why they can't be as successful as the top American group. I mean, the pop artists seem to be, you know what I mean? So why can't the rap scene be, you know? Only you can answer that, and only you can make a difference with that as well. I think the success in with certain people being very successful in rap does place them with a burden, you know what I mean? That others look at them and go, okay, they're responsible, you know, they have a responsibility, you know what I mean? In certain senses, that's true. So I'll leave it like that.
What would you do that you get, for example, $1 million?
What would I do if I had $1 million? Well, I'll tell you something, I'd do the lottery often at home. Yeah, that's the point. You know, I would like to...
You would spend a lot of money for the records,
It would be something naturally in what I feel comfortable in, and I would definitely have a music business in some sense. And, I mean, if I did do that, you know, I wouldn't be like some kind of... I don't see myself as a charity. You know, I see myself as providing a service, you know what I mean? I don't believe in giving a charity, you know what I mean? Because charity can make people very lazy. I believe we all have a job on this planet, and we have to, you know, we will have to input into that. So, you know, but I think I'll be a more realistic ear than what the industry give us from the underground street credit to have, you know what I mean? You know, I would like to see a lot more successful radio stations in the UK, because there's only really one black radio station, that's Choice FM, which is a station I do mixes on for a guy called 279 who presents a rap show. And you know, this is the only real black music show that plays constant black music, and they can't yet get a London-wide license. You know what I mean? So I would like to see something like that, more black radio stations, black TV companies, you know.
What do you think, how much strong influence of TV, press, media are for any kind of music? For example, for the rap music.
Well, I think the media, obviously, they influence those who don't know enough about it, which I call them the
do
sheep.
Do they create the taste?
I would say that the media are like shepherds, mm-hmm. and for people who do not know enough and haven't investigated, you know, will follow the shepherds, you know what I mean? The shepherds are there to lead the sheep. Mm-hmm. So I say, if you really want to know the facts about something, do your homework, do your history, find it out about it yourself, you know? It's the same thing about the projection that me from the UK have got about Croatia, you know? We've seen the wars, we've seen everything, we're like, okay, you know, boy, things are tough. You know, Bosnia and everything else. But being here now and seeing how warm everyone is here, you know, I've eaten lots and lots of food, you know, I've been made welcome, you know. And the show last night, the energy that the people had, that they came out to enjoy themselves, that's what I'm about, you know. That's why I'll perform anywhere in the world, you know. I don't care, because as far as I'm concerned, my job is a DJ. So I'm going to play music for people who want to hear music and enjoy themselves. That's what I go out to do, enjoy myself. I don't go out to be depressed, cause trouble, you know. I go out to enjoy myself. And I personally think, you know, the media, you know, what we probably need is the kind of, we need a younger ear that are working in the media as well, that have a more realistic point of view. Because these media people, you know, they just, you know, they'll just look into it. They're looking at the book, but not looking inside the book. You know what I mean? They look at the cover and think, okay, for example, this is my cover of my LP. They'll look at that and say, oh, he looks very aggressive. You know?
I don't like it.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. They don't know me.
Yes.
You know, oh, look, there's a wall, he sprayed that wall. That was a nice piece of brickwork. And, mm-hmm. you know, they're not looking at the art, they're not looking at the bold colours, they're not looking at, oh, look, there's a smashed turntable in there, he's probably violent. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
Yes.
So that's what they're looking at. They're not looking at what's the contents. They're looking at just the cover. Yeah.
Swift. So what's your impressions about yesterday's party we had?
For me, it's definitely one of the best concerts I've ever done in my life. It's definitely. I'm not just saying that. I don't say things I don't mean. I don't seriously say things I don't mean. It's not going to get me anywhere. Maybe get me back here a couple more times.
Yeah,
but
definitely.
But you know, it was fantastic. You know, I felt a great warmth from the crowd, and you know, that's what I like. You know, I mean, that show was for Croatia. You know, that show will probably never be repeated again. You know, the records, you know, you can play records, you can do a performance, but it's never always the same.
Not from that.